virus, people. So this is an interesting little video. So when I first saw it, I didn't read this before. And I didn't know this was a mare and the other three were geldings. So I'm going to watch it now again with you guys and see what's going on here. So this is the mare Toffee. And it's on Claudia L's channel if you want to go watch the video without me yapping. Or go interact with her or sub or like or whatever. So I think she's on a horse because of the way they're walking. So she's following her horse here, and let's see what happens. I'll turn the music down in a minute. So remember, this is a new paddock that she just kind of let it in. Okay? I just let my mare Toffee back into a large paddock after spent a few weeks in the adjoining paddock. So she wasn't with these horses. So this is a new interaction and a new herd. She's coming into a new herd. Did that horse just shoo off that bird? So there must be this little bird here bearing something. Watch the horse head to tell this bird, quit squawking at me. Look at that. Throw the head up, warning, get away. Claiming the dirt, wants to roll in the dirt. New paddock, horses always want to roll. This obviously looks like a roll spot because it's all dirt. Horses have started to roll here. They all smell the same as their pasture. They're all getting bug protection and a dusting to keep the flies off, maybe to build up some sun and heat protection. So she wants to get in her new little roll area, new horses, new area. She wants to be part of the herd and smell like them. So she goes here where she smells the other horses and she rolls. Really, really great dappling. Beautiful horse. Coffee. I'm going to turn the sound off here in a second. Okay, so she has a good dusting. She smells like the herd. When a horse rolls, there's a lot of dust that stays on them. And when you shake, you're going to see a lot of stuff fall. That's a lot of dust.
Toffee!
Okay, so immediately when her owner gave her a little kind of like push or put a little pressure on her or got a little excited, the horse responded, kind of bucks, farts, and runs off.
Toffee! Toffee!
Okay, so the horse runs off, had to get the lay of the land, checked out the escapes, checked out where she'd go, maybe checked for dangers, obstacles, threats, predators. And she spotted the other horses, so there she goes. I'm going to go ahead and music down, or the sound down, because really nothing else happens. So she runs over, very flashy, tail up, head arced, bowing up. Remember, when I was in high school, the coach would always say, don't bow up on me, because that means you're giving me resistance, you're trying to freaking challenge me. And coaches didn't like that shit. So that used to be a big term here in Texas, don't bow up on me. And, you know, if two guys were about to fight, they would say, hey, they're bowing up on each other, meaning they were about to fight. So she's trying to bow up, look big, strong, tail up, run, impress the herd that she's a healthy mare. Throwing that head, flashy, tail up, and they're watching. Hey, who's this crazy new mare? Shit, there's a crazy woman in a herd now. These three are geldings. And she comes right in the middle. Hey, boys. I'm the new girl in town. Kind of introduces herself. These two kind of, all right, whatever. Don't be too rowdy. This little one here, I think, if I had to guess, was the youngest gelding of the three. Because he's like a little teenager with, you know, some high school girl hitting on him or something. And he is just like all impressed with himself. And he wants to get closer and he wants to follow around. But she really doesn't want to have anything to do with him. Matter of fact, she starts pushing him. So the other two horses kind of like, okay, who's this girl? Let's check her out. Kind of bows up on him a little bit, showing strength. That horse held his ground, didn't yield, didn't run away. This horse yields a little bit more. I don't know if he yields here, but he will yield in a minute. Bowing up, and she kind of cooks on to this horse. this horse might be the highest or the oldest. I don't know. But he's like, whatever. If you want to come in my herd, you got to impress me. I'm not impressing you. So I don't think he really responded to her flirtiness or jumping in here saying, hey guys, I'm new. Can I get in your herd? But as these two kind of hook up, the young one, he's like, oh yeah, fresh meat. I'm all over it. So he kind of runs over to her and starts trying to like have a courting relationship with her. These two are kind of like, whatever, let the youngster go try and impress her and wear her out. Then she'll come back to one of us. Remember the story of the two bulls on the hill? And a young bull says, dad, let's run down and mate with one of the cows. And the dad says, no, son, let's walk down and mate with them all. All right. So this is the young guy kind of. And she's like, I don't know if she's about to go and heat. A lot of mares, they call it presenting themselves or presenting their smell. She's not really lifting her tail, but she is. I don't know if this is, it's hard for me to tell. Is she presenting herself for him to see what he'll do? Or is she kind of like pushing him to threaten with the butt? I'm a little confused on that. Seth, I kind of think because she spread out, she was presenting herself to him. And he didn't know what to do, or he just ran off and said, hey, follow me. We both ran over here together. And she kind of bonds up and hooks on a little bit. Now, it changes in a minute to where he's like trying to lead her. He's creating a draw, an interest, and it's pulling her to him like you do in a round pen. So as he walks off, his ears are back, but they weren't back. Notice these ears here. Okay, hang on. She goes back. See these ears back? That's not threatening. He's kind of listening and watching her. He sees her out of his peripheral, at his monocular, when he's using one eye, mono. He's using his monocular vision to see her, and he's using his ear to hear her and see her with his ear and his eye. So he's keeping an ear and eye on her, and he's creating a draw. They're actually creating a draw for these two. So these guys are moseying over here. This one seems like it's following this one. Maybe this is the high gelding. I'm still not sure, and I don't know if I figure it out by the end of this, but we'll see. She's in the middle. She feels safe. I got other horses around me. Mares are usually kept in the middle. The geldings are on the outside, or stallions are on the outside to protect, kick, keep predators away, protect the children and the women. Kind of like we used to do in human world until we got into, I don't know what bathroom to use, and I don't know what I'm supposed to do, and everything's confused, and I don't know what I want to be called, and whatever. Horses don't have to worry about that crap. So they've already had a chance to smell her. She's rolled. She's kind of in the middle of the herd, but they're still all a little curiosity. You know what? I just saw these horses here. Hang on. Right here. Watch this. Watch his nose. Watch this guy's nose right here. They're catching a scent to her. I can't tell if there's a lot of wind, but my guess is the wind is going this way because this guy shows what we used to call training dogs a JND, just noticeable difference. When do you see that first change in a dog's behavior that he picked up a scent? Right here is where this horse gave me a JND and he just picked up a scent. So his head was low and now watch it go up. He's picking up the air. His head went up and he picked up some air. So my guess is the wind's blowing this way and it blew her scent over to him. So a little stall here in the action. Kind of what do we do? These guys are eating. This one's here. He took a step. She follows. So he's walking off saying, follow me. And then I think she gets a little ear pinny and pushy. These guys found a new something to eat. So now he's kind of flashing her and saying, hey, look at me. She's throwing her head. I'm chasing you. He's running and playing, kicking and bucking, showing, hey, I'm strong. You know, come with me. I'll be a good herd leader. You can be my girl. This is a courting process a little bit. And she's being pretty playful. Now, I don't know if she's playing with him because he's young. And she's not thinking of a relationship. Normally, a strong gelding will ignore a male and make her ask and kind of beg to be in the herd. And so this isn't what I would call normal stallion. Or I'd like to know how this turned out on who she ended up bonding with and who got her as his mare. Because one of these three is going to claim her and it'll be theirs. Pretty cute. Man, my coffee's freaking too hot. I drank the last two sips. I burnt the crap out of myself. All right. So she's smelling him. They're close. They're kind of bonding and hanging out. He's on alert. She can relax now and eat because she's got somebody watching over her. These two are kind of moseying over there. All right, let's go see what the youngsters are up to, whatever. So when I see this right here, this guy keeps following this one. I don't know if this one is old and this one's following it kind of like to help it, or I don't know if this one's stronger and this one is following because this one's dominant. I can't really see enough behavior to figure out these two. But fly mask, they may be great for keeping the flies off horses, but they take away their vision and they make horses insecure. Now, horses adapt to pressure very easily and very quickly. They have to. That's why it's so easy to desensitize a horse. If a horse was reactive to everything that moved and didn't move and everything all the time, they could never eat and they could never relax. Because of that, they have this ability to desensitize very quickly. So when you put a mask on them and they lose some of their vision and it's hard to see, they desensitize to it very quickly and they accept it. I'm not saying it's good. I really don't like fly mask at night because I think they need to see. But most people put them on. They're too damn lazy to take them off. That's why I don't like them. But if you're diligent about it, they can keep the flies off during the day. So what do we got going on here? Okay, so this guy's still kind of leading, trying to get her to follow. She's hanging, but she doesn't really want to follow. She's showing her flank there, kind of like, hey, come back to me. Maybe she'll walk off, create a draw. Maybe she'll come to him. Okay, she came to him. Now, maybe she came to him because these two are getting closer, and these two are creating a draw. Remember, nothing happens out here in a vacuum. Can't step in the same river twice. Once you step in it, you change the flow, the ripples. It's never the same river. You stir up dust. You can never step on the same in the same river twice, and you never ride the same horse twice. Because once you ride him, you both changed, and everything is different. So right here, there's a lot of interaction. She's kind of creating draw. She's flirting. These two are coming over. They're creating a draw to her. Maybe they're creating a draw to him. Maybe they're going to want to come over and take her from him. He may have to defend. Lots of dynamics that we have to see here. So they're moseying on over, not over anxious and chasing, showing a little interest. She's kind of like, look at my pretty spots and my pretty mane, and I spent all night blow drying my heart hair, and I combed it all night, and I got the ends highlighted. What do you think, boys? And they ignore her. Whatever. Crazy woman. Rick, why do you hate? I don't hate. Shut up, you freaking crazy. All right. So again, notice she always somehow ends up in the middle of the herd. So, okay, this is not by accident. This is by design. So she's kind of like, I think, flirting with all three, saying, who's going to step up and claim me or come over and show me that you're worthy of me? A lot of talking going on here. So she seems like she's a little attracted to this guy. She keeps kind of circling around. I mean, it could be a little bit of a tease, these guys. She's showing her flanks, letting them smell, maybe flash tail, but she kind of keeps going back. This guy might be her favorite. I don't know. So right here, I think, is where it changes. He was drawing her before, and she was following. And right about here, I think it changes, and she starts pushing and driving him. So when he's creating a draw and pulling her in, he's kind of, you know, using his draw and saying, come with me, follow me, and hooking on and latching on. But I think it changes right here. She starts pushing and driving him. So pushed him a little bit. She stopped an eight. She's still in the middle. Notice she's in the middle of all the geldings. Still kind of going after him. These two are still kind of following and showing a little bit of curiosity. This is the bar scene. She's over here. This guy's over here. Can I buy you a drink? Hey, baby, blah, blah, blah. These guys are at the end of the bar kind of looking over saying, eh, should we send her a drink? Let's see if we can get some eye contact. So that's what's kind of, in human terms, maybe what's going on. And she, see, that was a little push a little bit. Right there, that wasn't a draw. Right now, he's kind of walking. But right here, I think it gets, she's pushing. She's putting pressure ahead to wave. She put a little bit more pressure and pushed him off. Now, I'm not saying she was telling him, get away from me, but she was showing a little bit of dominance and maybe testing to see how weak he was, how much he would put up with and would he yield to her pressure. And he did. So I don't know if that's a good or bad thing for her. It depends on what she's looking at and where she's at in her life and what kind of craziness she's going through this month. Rick, why do you hate... Oh, be quiet, you big crybaby. I just say that shit to fire up you crazy, bra-burning, crazy women. Still in the middle. Other Gelding's in front waiting for her. She walks in. He walks off slowly now, kind of drawing her. There's a little bit of a dance and courtship going here. Even though she's kind of pushing and following, there's still a little playful flirting and getting to know each other here. Really cute video. And that's how it ends. So, I did it. Claudia, hopefully you got something out of it. She asked, hopefully Rick at Think Like a Horse will give us another informative behavior. Hopefully it was informative. Again, you know, people, when me or anyone else does this, we're guessing. We're guessing through experience and knowledge that we have in our life, but it's still a guess because nobody knows a horse better than a horse. So when I do these, I'm trying to put it in human terms so human can understand it. But there is no greater teacher of the horse than the horse itself, which is why trainers and people that are always talking about, I got to train, I got to teach my horse how to carry his head, I got to show my horse how to do this, I have to show him that I'm boss. All that crap tells me that you really don't understand, you don't know horses, because the horse is the best teacher of the horse. And if you learn how to speak horse, horses are pretty kind of simple and they're easy to understand and predict. Horses are not unpredictable. Never the horse's fault. Buddy, Mr. T. Ransom, you're all good boys. These little horses are cute. And we'll end that there. Y'all have a good day.